Namaste everyone, I am Gyan and you are watching the first video of session 16 of Java and Web, Assertion in Java. In this video, I will introduce you with the concept of assertion. The main purpose of assertion is debugging. Debugging is correction of program at compile time or runtime when we do not get our expected output. Here we have the Java file example.java which contains the class example. Inside the method main of the class example, we have defined an integer variable x which contains the value 9. After that, we have an if statement which is checking if x is equal to 8 or not. Here in this case, when we have assigned the value 9 to the variable x, actually we did it by mistake. We have intended to assign the value 8 to the variable x, but by mistake we have assigned the value 9 to the variable x. Since as a programmer, I did not realize my mistake. I was expecting hello to get printed. But it does not happen. By mistake at line number 5, means this line, I have written int x is equal to 9 instead of writing int x is equal to 8. Now I have to check what mistake I did. If this was a very long code, then it is really hard to find what mistake I did. So to check my mistake, that what mistake I did, I have written this statement in between the variable declaration and the if statement. To check my mistake, deliberately I wrote system.out.println and the value of x just before the if statement. Again I run the code and I found my mistake, corrected it and got my expected output. But just after correcting my mistake, I forgot to remove the system.out.println statement. That's why while execution, I got 8 as output, which was not expected. If this was a really long code, then it was very hard to find the extra statement which I have written in between the integer variable declaration and the if statement. We need something for debugging, using which we do not need to remove the debugging line from the code after debugging it. I should be able to enable or disable the debugging lines as we need. Means the debugging line will be present there and I can enable or disable that debugging line as we need. We can achieve this goal by using assertion. We will learn more about assertion in the coming videos of this session. That's all for this video guys. Don't forget to like and share this video, subscribe my channel on YouTube, like my page on Facebook and leave your valuable comments in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.